Good morning, students. Today I am going to start chapter number 6, Human Resources from Geography. And today I will discuss only one topic, distribution of population. So students, you know very well that in all over the world, people are a nation's greatest and superior resource in the compare of other resources, whatever provided by God to us. Okay? And nature's bounty, it means whatever things like atmosphere, oxygen, and trees, and flora and fauna, or animals, and natural vegetation, water, soil, all these are given by God to us. But all these things becomes important only when people find it useful. And it is only the people with their demands and abilities that turn all of above into very important resources according to their needs and according to their requirement. For example, only human can change wheat into a flour, and only human being can use cotton wool to change into a thread, and after that fabrics, and after that clothes. Okay? Alright. And human being can do all these conversion only on the basis of health, a good and complete education. Then anyone can change anything into more important resource. And human resource is the ultimate resource in the compare of other resources. And healthy, educated, skilled and motivated people develop resources according to their requirements and need to fulfill their day-by-day requirements. Understood? So, as you know very well that, like other resources, land, soil, water, and natural vegetation and animals are not equally distributed in all over the world, as well as like human resources also not equally distributed all over the world. It means their total population is also varying from one country to another country, and their educational level, their age and their gender, and also the characteristics also keep changing continuously in all over the world, and even one country to another country. It means, I want to clear one thing here, that everything is unequally distributed in all over the country, as well as the total number of people country wise also changing year by year and from one country to another country. So students, on the basis of topic number 1, distribution of population, we will see that how people are unequally distributed in all over the world. And students, the way in which people are spread across the earth's surface or living in one country to another country is known as the pattern of population distribution. Okay? It's mean the way in which people are spread or living across the surface of the earth in a different country is known as the pattern of population distribution. Okay? And students, near about more than 90% of the world's population lives only in about 10% of the land surface. And also, the distribution or the total number of population in all over the world is extremely uneven. As I told you above that 90% of the world's population lives in about 10% of the land surface, because these 10% part of the world have a very good climatic condition and availability of resources and also normal temperature and climatic condition. That's why most of the people living in these 10% parts of the earth. And students, some part of the earth are very crowded and some are very less populated or sparsely populated. And the crowded areas of the earth are South and Southeast Asia, Europe, and Northeastern and North America. Okay? And as well as very less number of people live in high latitude areas like in northernmost part of North America, Greenland, and northernmost part of the USSR or Antarctica, etc. Okay? And also less number of people living in tropical desert like cold desert and hot desert of the world, and very less number of people also living in high mountainous areas and equatorial forest like in the region of Amazon forest, like in the Himalayas. Very less number of people living here due to very high rainfall in Amazon and very cold climatic condition in the region of Himalayas and very hot climatic condition in hot desert and due to the very cold climatic conditions in a cold deserts of the world. Okay? And students, the number of people or more people live north of the equator in the compare of the south of the equator. And almost 3/4 of the world people live in 2 continents only. And these continents are Asia and Africa. And students, here I want to one thing clear in front of you, that the imaginary line equator, which is divided our world equally into 2 halves, and as I told you above that most or more people live in the north of the equator, and you can see that most of the world greatest countries are located above the equator in the north, like North America and Europe and Russia and India and China and also Arabian Peninsula or Arabian countries of the world. Okay? And in the south of the equator, you can see only some countries of the world like South America, African continent, and Australia. Okay? And after that, near about 60% of the world's people stay or living only in 10 countries. And all 10 countries of the world have more than 100 million people. Okay? And these countries are number one, China, number two, India, number three, USA, number four, Indonesia, number five, Brazil, number six, Pakistan, number seven, Bangladesh, number eight, Russia, number nine, Nigeria, and number 10, Japan. So students, from 1 to 10, these are the 10 countries of the world in which near about more than 100 million people are living. So my dear students, on the basis of above explanation, now you can understand that how and why people are unequally distributed in all over the world. All right. So students, for today's that's all. And in my next explanation, I will discuss with you density of population and factor affecting distribution of population. Okay? Thank you and have a nice day.